Without understanding, you can't interpret the emptiness of the tomb, because in reality, this empty tomb was not meant to prove the resurrection. The empty tomb cannot prove the resurrection, because any other thing could have made that tomb empty. It's possible that they stole his body. During Jesus' time, they were stealing, raiding tombs. Yeah, they were tomb raiders or robbers. They would go to any tomb, remove it, and look for, because some people were buried with treasures and all of that. So it's possible that some people could have stolen it. So in the scheme of divine plan, the emptiness of the tomb was not meant to be a foolproof of the resurrection. Rather, the resurrection is the explanation of the empty tomb. I don't know whether that is clear. The emptiness of the tomb was not meant to. In other words, you don't need the tomb to be empty before you know that the resurrection has happened. If you had understood and believed what Jesus was saying all the while, what the empty tomb would do would be to confirm what you had. And that's what happened to John. It was coming. But for Peter and Mary, because they couldn't understand, they could not interpret. When you lack understanding, you cannot interpret. If you don't understand that your enemies cannot stop your destiny, you will be doing the stupid things that people are doing. You'll be running up and down, hitter skater, doing the unnecessary things that you shouldn't do. That sometimes the equation of your success, there is a part where the enemy is either the denominator or the numerator. I think it's numerator they call it, but so you will not be busy trying to kill your enemies that you can't kill. Proverbs chapter 16, verse 7. If God be pleased with the life of any man, he will make even his enemies his friends. Psalm 23, he has prepared a banquet for me. Where? So why are you killing your enemies? Die by fire, die by fire. Let me remind you again, this is why God is not preparing banquet for some people. Because God wants to prepare your banquet before your enemies. But you have killed all your enemies. So God is like, so before whom now am I going to prepare your banquet? Oh yeah, keep killing them. Let them be dying, if I thought they are even dying. If you understand that enemies cannot stop you, you will be like Joseph. You will be like David. He was anointed for the crown. But Saul pursued him for years. What did David do? He ran. Did he take revenge on Saul? But here is the deal. When God has anointed you for something, as you are running, that thing is chasing you. So David was running, but the palace was chasing him. David was running, but the palace was what? Chasing him. He was not aggressive to Saul. When it was time, it came. Let me tell somebody, understanding, understanding. Without understanding, you cannot interpret. Something that should give you joy will become a source of perplexity for you. You can't, if you don't understand the inevitable, instead of preparing yourself for it, you'll be doing useless things to avoid it. To watch full videos and get notifications for new ones, please subscribe to my YouTube channel. God bless you.
Sign up with the largest community of Catholics online. Meet new friends, chat, post pictures and videos, make and receive audios and video calls, interact with lots of priests and religions. Download the app from Google Play Store.